So there's a question I've been trying to answer for a really long time. What's the best way to teach people about science? I think about this a lot, and I want to share my thoughts with you. Let's start at the beginning. Too early. So I studied science, like psychology, biology, even neurobiology, and it was pretty fun. I landed a job with Australia's National Science Agency, and I traveled to schools, teaching kids and teenagers about all areas of science.
Hello, morning, yeah. My name is Vanessa.
And I came across some research, which found that children have formed an opinion about science, either positive or negative, by the age of 7, which surprised me. So I was pretty motivated to show young kids how amazing science is. I took workshops to kids in remote tropical islands. I went to Papua New Guinea, and I even gave astronomy talks in the middle of Australia. More researchers found that problem solving is a much better approach in education than lectures and memorization. And since most of my classes were hands-on, I was pretty happy.
Welcome to Mythbusters for the April school holidays. What we're doing today are going through 2 demonstrations and 8 hands-on myths that everyone will have to bust.
And then I discovered YouTube. It intrigued me that a 5-minute video had the potential to reach millions of people, when I could only see a couple hundred students every week. But is online education as effective as place-based education? And does one have more of an impact than the other? I pondered these questions for a couple of years. Also, did I want to put my face all over the internet? I procrastinated for a while. I did a master's degree in science communication, and then I decided it's time. Braincraft was born. And it's been 2 and a bit years of trying to be a better writer and animator and editor. I tried to do some interactive things to get back to that problem-solving approach, and I just made a lot of videos to see what you guys liked. And then I stopped and thought, what is the best way to teach or inspire people about science? In videos, there's a spectrum of edutainment. On the education side, you have something textbook inspired, like Crash Course. And on the entertainment side, you have something that feels like a movie, like Vsauce 3. Is one more effective than the other? So I asked Will, my supervisor from my master's research. He always has words to say.
That's a hard question because both of them are really important. Now, I got to say, one, they do different jobs. One, up the storytelling, entertainment, documentary style, is really about grabbing you and about saying why this is important, why it's worth listening to. The other end is, you know, there's a time and a place for a textbook. Look, I think the gap and the harder work is to do entertainment that grabs you and to say why something's important.
Still, I thought I'd experiment and try something on the entertainment side of the spectrum, and the quality side of the quality versus quantity spectrum. But that's kind of hard to do by yourself. This is when the YouTube space stepped in. They very kindly provided me with a crew.
My name's Ali Bricado, and I'm the DP on this production.
My name is Lena Al-Khatib, and I'm the sound mixer for this project.
And another stop-motion animator.
Hi, I'm Jennifer, and I am a stop-motion animator. I'm helping Vanessa today.
To help bring my ideas to life. I wanted to create a beautiful animation about the work of a really cool scientist, Elizabeth Blackburn. I interviewed her first.
Mm-hmm. Are there any steps that you take in your personal life that have come from your research to try and be a healthier person?
Yes, yes. And so the work in utilities, which then grew into collaboration with people.
And then we got to work animating for weeks. But why stop at one video? At the same time, I was planning a more cinematic approach. I wanted to walk through this 4-room set at the YouTube space, somewhat like Birdman, and explore memory and forgetting. I even directed something for the first time ever.
Cool. Have you had female directing mentors? And
this is the first thing I've ever directed. I have no mentors. I don't know what I'm doing. I have no idea. Do you think it's going well, Christopher?
I think it's going great.
And almost 3 months after I first wrote the 2 scripts, I'd finished my experiments. But what is the best way to teach people about science? What were my results? Really, there's no one answer to this question. There's benefits to different methods of teaching and experience for different audiences. So there's no perfect formula. But in the process of making these videos, I realized that if you stop questioning things and thinking critically about what you're creating, you stop learning how to improve. It's just like how scientists work. The process of science has so many connections to our everyday lives. And for me, experimenting with different formats was really valuable in testing the boundaries of what I can create. No matter how old you are, you should never stop doing experiments.